Stop for a moment and recall your fondest childhood memory, or your worst. In either case, there's a really good chance that it's false memory. Research has consistently found that our memories from when we were kids are either extremely inaccurate or didn't happen at all. They're just elaborate constructions of a memory storage system that isn't very good at distinguishing real memories from fake ones. So what if we told you that there was a way to do this on purpose? To hack your brain into believing and seeing vividly a completely made-up event that never actually happened. The trick is, you need somebody else to do it for you, and no Total Recall-style brain hacking machines. For instance, in a study in 1995, researchers sat down a group of people and mentioned four incidents from their childhood gathered from family members, and asked subjects how well they remembered them. What they didn't mention was that one of the stories, with them being lost in a specific shopping mall, didn't really happen. It didn't matter. 20% came back with sudden memories of the event that, in reality, never happened. The sheer act of asking them if it did caused them to manufacture the memory, filling in details on the fly. In another test, an unsuspecting group of people who had visited Disneyland in the past were placed in a room with a cardboard cutout of Bugs Bunny and were shown fake ads for Disneyland featuring Bugs. Afterwards, 40% claimed they vividly remembered seeing a guy in a Bugs Bunny costume when they were at Disneyland. They didn't, of course. Bugs isn't a Disney character. Another study took it a step further and actually photoshopped a picture of each subject riding in a hot air balloon. When asked if they recalled this non-event, 50% said they did. Other experiments successfully convinced people they had at one time nearly drowned, been hospitalized, or been attacked by a wild animal. So how does it work? Your brain kind of plays it fast and loose when it stores memories, and for a good reason. Usually, the details don't matter. You remember your best friend's phone number, but don't remember exactly where and when he told you. You remember that you hate zucchini, but don't remember what day of the week you tried it. Your brain breaks up memories into a stew of general lessons learned and important stuff you'll need later. The problem is that same process makes it very difficult to distinguish real memories from fake ones, since the source of a memory is so often discarded in the stew. A fact you think you read in a newspaper might in reality have been read in a fictional novel, or heard from a friend, or dreamed or implanted by somebody who's playing with you. A new study in mice attempts to create false memories of experiences the mice never had. What the researchers in the current study did was put mice in a blue room and looked at the pattern of brain cells that activated. They then tagged those cells so that they would respond to a certain frequency of light by firing. The next day, the same mice were placed in a red room and given a small electric shock to encode a fear response. At the same time, the researchers shone light into the mouse brains to activate their memories of the blue room. They then put them back into the blue room, at which time the mice had a fear reaction. The mice froze, demonstrating a typical fear response, even though they had never been shocked while there. The next step, of course, is to actually do something with these findings. The research group would like to use its memory manipulation technology to treat undesirable brain function, such as anxiety and depression. Perhaps more excitingly is the potential to directly encode new memories into your neurons, kind of like when Neo learns to fly a helicopter in The Matrix. That's probably a few years away yet. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos.